Hi, my name is Gábor Gyenes. I'm an academic cardiologist at Mezenkopska Alberta Heart Institute in Edmonton and a professor of medicine at the University of Alberta. The three main pillars of work of an academic physician are the clinical work, the research, and the teaching. Clinically, a cardiologist's job is to rule in and out heart disease. We are trained to do and interpret diagnostic tests, and we decide whether medications are the best treatment or if patients need any interventions. There are several interventions, such as stenting or pacemaker implantations, that are done by specially trained cardiologists, and there are cardiac surgeons who do surgery if necessary. I was originally trained in medicine and cardiology in Hungary, and I did some further training in Toronto before I received a job offer in Edmonton. My job description includes about 50% of clinical work. A university professor is a teacher, educator, and supervisor of learners on many levels. I spend about a third of my time with teaching. Anything I do clinically or in research, I'm accompanied by medical students, observers, residents, and fellows. The third pillar of an academic physician's job is research. I was specially trained in research before I came to Canada. I completed my PhD thesis in Sweden. Here at the University of Alberta, I have a 10% research portfolio that gives me the luxury of picking and choosing what projects I want to do. If you're thinking of a career in medicine, before you make up your mind what you want to do, you need to find out if you can live with that everyday routine of that specialty. We all do things that excite us, however, we do many things that are frankly rather boring. Does a specialty give you too much stress or not enough stimulation? You need to have some personal experience about this. I really enjoy interacting with my patients. Many don't necessarily believe me at first, so it is really rewarding when they realize later that the path I suggested exceeded their expectations. After years of experience, you more or less know what the likely outcome will be, but for the patient, it is their first experience with this particular problem. Taking the time to make sure they understand what you're telling them might be crucial to be successful in this business, because oftentimes it's a communication problem and patients don't end up following your advice. Why did I choose cardiology? Well, I fell in love with cardiology because it is logical and a lot can be done about preventing as well as diagnosing and treating heart disease. I also had excellent mentors. This is often why we choose our career. I was hired as a research assistant to work with Hungary's best cardiologist as a MS student. Her lab was not my first choice, so I didn't realize at the time that this decision would turn out to be a defining moment for me. I got lucky again when I chose a research topic. I started research in an area where I could work with my father, who was a radiation oncologist. Later it turned out that one of the best medical centers in the world, the Karolinska Institute in Sweden, was looking for a cardiologist with interest in that particular research topic, so I could start working with them, and I managed to complete a PhD over several years with them. All of these experiences and achievements helped me when I applied for a clinical fellowship at Mount Sinai Hospital in Toronto. So my advice to you, if you are interested in cardiology or medicine, get some experience, observe what a cardiologist does, participate in some research if possible, and keep an open mind. Sometimes things don't go exactly the way you're planning them, but you will find your calling eventually. And if you already know what your chosen path will be, make sure you keep a balance between work and private life, as you will likely work for several decades. And just make sure that you enjoy this journey. Thank you for listening.